Hi, this is Vincent Shkreli from the Daily Caller News Foundation. I'm here with Denver Riggleman, Congressman from Virginia, and his wife, Christine Riggleman, who is CEO of Silverback Distillery. And you guys have taken it upon yourselves to create a whiskey hand sanitizer during this pandemic. Can you explain to us how that came about?
I'm going to let the CEO talk about that. I think she probably
So I'm a master distiller. I usually make whiskey at our family business, and we have two of our daughters that are pregnant. And about 2 months ago, I said, you know what? Let me just try to make some hand sanitizer just for them in case people run out. And nobody was out at the time. And I made a batch. And then I provided it to our staff and customers, and, you know, just on the counter. And they're like, I need this. Like, nobody has it. We just looked at each other. We're like, oh, no. We have friends that are, you know, first responders, you know, nurses, police officers, and they said, oh, well, we need it. And so we immediately made some orders and placed the supply orders, and it's just been crazy ever since. So instead of making whiskey and distilling that, I'm distilling hand sanitizer.
Can you explain to us the support that you guys got out of, you know, going through with this endeavor to, you know, create the sanitizer?
Yeah, it's been overwhelming. We didn't have the supplies on hand other than the grains and the equipment and the skill set to be able to do it. So we immediately went online and listed supplies for donations. And it's been overwhelming what people have given us and donated towards what we've been doing, because we didn't have all the ingredients that were necessary to finish it off. We had the distillate, which is the alcohol high enough that's required for the main ingredient, but we didn't have the other ingredients. So we've had to flex on the fly very quickly.
What we found out, I tell you, you know, I deployed after 9/11, and I think what's been amazing is there's sort of that same spirit of America coming together that we've seen here, especially from the hospitals. I was just in a COVID-19 testing lab yesterday, and they're the ones who have our hand sanitizer, Vincent. So that's been pretty incredible. But when she talks about people coming together, we've had places like Star Hill Brewery who want to donate their beer to make liquor, but also Horton Winery donated 7,000 gallons, and Trump Winery, which is in our district, is going to donate 8,000 gallons. And while that, we can make ethanol at a high enough proof off of our still that we can make really FDA-approved, CDC-approved hand sanitizer for all these hospitals and for all these emergency workers. We had somebody come in the parking lot the other day and was in tears about what we're doing. And she goes, hey, Denver, you know, I'm a Democrat, but what you're doing is amazing. And I said, don't thank me. Thank the CEO, you know, who's sitting to my right now. He's an amazing individual. I said, but, you know, I was carrying out, I think I surprised people yesterday, Vincent. I was carrying out bottles
jugs,
of hand sanitizer.
Yeah.
They're like, Congressman, you're now delivering hand sanitizer? Like, whatever we got to do. So the support in the community has been, I will tell you, it's been emotional, and it's been incredible, especially going up and seeing the COVID testing labs yesterday and going into the COVID tower at the University of Virginia and seeing patients. That is really an eye-opener, and it really it hits you how bad this crisis is.
So how are you guys handling everything else? I mean, I personally, I know you're working on the hand sanitizer, but personally, as you guys moving through this situation, how have you felt the impact of the situation?
Well, I'll start on this one, and she can say the impact from this. You know, I'm also in Congress. So not only Congress, but we have a business that we also have to make sure we take care of our employees. You know, we have the same type of issues that other businesses have during this time. But I've seen it's just been sort of incredible that not only has the hand sanitizer exploded, but people are supporting local businesses up and down our road for curbside pickup, delivery, or shipment of those type of the alcohol that we do. So not only are we trying to build hand sanitizer, we're trying to produce, and I have my congressional duties. So really right now it's been about 14 to 16 hours a day for me, which is okay. I mean, there's 730,000 people who have it worse than I do. And my job is to serve them. And for Christine, you know, she's been working probably from dark early before the sun comes up
every day
and gets home after dark. And you know, with daylight savings time, you're talking 8:30, she gets in, and we just get the dishes done, collapse.
I fell asleep sitting up last night.
She did. She fell asleep sitting up. And, you know, I wish I took a picture for you, Vince. It would have been fun to watch. But I guess Christine talked about it's been just juggling that with two pregnant daughters, with another daughter who's now filling in on the filling line. We've converted our entire manufacturing plant to hand sanitizer. It has been one of the biggest challenges we've ever done. And, you know, this is a incredible woman who not only is doing amazing things for people, but she had to sit through and raise our children when I was deployed for 11 years, almost straight, six times. And now she's doing this. I think service is in her blood. I think it's in our family's DNA. But Christine, I mean, she probably has some inputs on how it's been with the community going forward, you know, going forward and what we're doing right now.
Yeah, it's been absolutely overwhelming, the need. We thought we'd maybe get, you know, maybe 20, 30 orders. When we put it online, our phones were going off till like 2 or 3 a.m. People were up trying to email us, trying to, you know, I need it, I need it, I need it. And so we had no idea that the demand was so great for it.
We've had almost 1,100 requests, Vincent. 1,100. That's from across the country. Yeah. I would say 700 to 800 of them are medically related. We're giving it away for free. I think we've gotten through the first 300 or 400 requests. I think we have between, and I know these are crazy numbers, I think we have on the medical side about 363 more after the first 300 or 400 that we've done. And we have massive spreadsheets. We have ways to register where you can get this, but it's actually transferring not only the manufacturing, but our technology over to absorbing this kind of volume. It's been extraordinary. And it's still coming in every day on a level I never thought we'd see. And this is from across the country. And yeah. I think people are saying that, you know, this is a pandemic. We have to come together to help each other. But you know, Christine, as the CEO, has not only had to absorb the amazing amount of manufacturing capacity that we had to do, she's had to absorb the technical challenges of prioritizing and rack and stacking all these things that are happening. And then we get 7,000 gallons from Horton Winery, 8,000 gallons pledged from Trump Winery. We have boxes coming in, and we have bottles coming in that are pledged. You should see our place, Vincent. It looks like, I mean, it's to the wall with boxes of stuff, and you got people snaking through, and there's sanitizer everywhere. I will tell you this. We have the cleanest facility in the world. If you spill anything in our place, there's no virus there. There's alcohol everywhere. So, you know, so we can make some alcohol and take a drink. Make some alcohol and take a drink. So we're doing okay, but that's where we're at right now.
It's been amazing how much people have come together. We have, right here, we have, this is a mask that, one of our customers made us, and it even has a gorilla theme, which is our theme of Silverback Distillery. And so like our customers are trying to help us out any way they can, as well as there's companies that are donating, jugs to us.
Yeah. So they're donating those gallon jugs, to us, which is, this is sanitizer here. And then we're using
glue bottles.
Glue bottles. We're buying them, amazing. Getting them donated. You know, we got, you know, we either have full service or self-service. You can maybe bring something by. We'll try to fill it if we got it.
But emotionally, everybody said that, you know, it's helping them lift their spirits, that we're helping out in a time of need. Look, we're like everybody else. We don't know business-wise, if we're going to survive this. We're doing everything we can to survive it, as well as everyone else, applying for all the loans and the grants that have been provided, you know, through the administration, and everything is very helpful. We have 30 employees. We have two locations, one in Virginia and one in Pennsylvania. So we're very unique that we have two distilleries. So we have two sets of employees that we need to, you know, make sure are okay. We also need some, the emotional part is, you know, a lot of people are at home, and our employees are working more hours than they have before. So it's, you know, trying to balance the, this is a scary time, but also we're needed right now. And so we need to step up to the plate, because we are the source for the hospitals right now that are near us. And they said, that's true. If we weren't providing to them, they wouldn't have any, and they're on the front line. So that's a lot of pressure, but it also feels very satisfying and is very humbling that we can help them in this time of need.
How do you guys think the Trump administration has handled the crisis?
Well, I just got off a call with the vice president in the GOP conference right before this call, Vincent. And it's been pretty incredible what they've had to navigate and what they're doing. And not only the president, who's been incredible in this, I believe. I've heard it. I've been on the calls. I've seen the challenges that are there. I think we're at a time right now where we should be getting through this together, and not, and you see still the political tribalism that's going on right now. I think it's a bit ridiculous. We see it in the Commonwealth of Virginia too. Listen, whether you're Republican or Democratic leader right now, the challenges are immense, and you're in a no-win situation many of the times. I think the president's done an incredible job. I also think the vice president's done an incredible job leading the task force. Just being on the call with him, I mean, I tell you, the organization that he's been able to put together, and his ability to be fluid and dynamic in this situation has been extraordinary. So I think they're doing a great job. And I'll say this, you know, every congressman, every congresswoman in every district, you know, has these same set of unique challenges. And when I say same set of unique, I know that sounds a little ironic, but all of us have this challenge of, you know, whether it's PPE or price gouging, right, or not enough test kits or SBA loans or PPP loans or EIDL loans, or what's the threshold, you know, between the Exchange Stabilization Fund and the SBA Express and SBA 7A loans, all these things we're fighting through every day. I think that right now, I think if we look at how we've adapted to this crisis, I believe that we're doing the best we can. We're not going to be perfect. Nothing's going to be perfect. But nobody expected a pandemic right now for COVID-19. And hopefully that curve flattens. You know, we've had some better news today. But I believe they've done a fantastic job. Well, you know, you were talking about people doing, you know, incredible things. I think what you see about America and what you saw with, you know, the spirit that we have is that people are just doing incredible things to help others. That's the spirit of Americans. I think also right now, we've been fortunate that I'm on the ground with small business issues because I'm on the small business working team, right, that has those requests are channeled up to Secretary Mnuchin. I'm also on Financial Services Committee. So I have an on-the-ground look of how the PPP program is working, how EIDL is actually working, what the banks are doing, what the confusion is, right, on saying authorizing the loans or executing the funds. I get to see all of this from the ground, and I think that's been very helpful to have a business to see this from the ground. And not only have we been able to see this from the ground, we're seeing the healthcare side also. So not just the business side. I think we're in the most fortunate position as a family to see both sides of the business side and the healthcare side. And just the fact that I'm fortunate enough to be in Congress right now, I believe, I don't know, sometimes I think you're at the right place at the right time. And I feel like our family is. And, you know, if we fail swinging the bat to help people, then that's how it goes. But we're not going to fail. Our business will be standing strong when we're done. Other people will be standing strong. We're just going to keep doing the right things. But I just think we're in a unique situation where our family has had such an incredible life experience in military and business. And now we have a CEO who can make hand sanitizer and a congressman who can look at the business side of this. We have both sides covered. And I think that's been, I don't know, I guess you could call it a blessing that we're in this position right now.
And we're in one of the most, for the distillery, for our family business, we're in the most, probably one of the most regulated businesses you could go into. And I apologize profusely sometimes about it because we didn't know how many different regulatory agencies we'd have to deal with when we first started this. But we are grateful that we're a part of an industry right now that can help out, that we can give something back, because there's so many people right now that, you know, that aren't in an industry, you know, involved in this. And we're very grateful that we have the equipment that can actually function with what we need and the skill set to do so. And so we're very humbled and very grateful to be able to do that. So it makes me very proud that our family, you know, two of our daughters are pregnant. They're working quarantine from home, but they are doing amazing with trying to organize all the details of everything and run both locations while we're doing the actual physical part of things. So our youngest stepped up. She just graduated from college and she's like, oh, I'm in charge of the sanitation line. Okay. You know, so she wasn't expecting to help out, but you know, she couldn't not help out. So, you know, everybody is pulled together. And I, as a mom and as their CEO, I couldn't be prouder.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. And thank you again for doing what you're doing, utilizing your facility to do, you know, to help out with the situation. It's phenomenal.
Thank you,
and please come visit us sometimes. We'd love to see you.
Oh, definitely. We'll have to have a drink.
Yeah, we've converted our tasting room. It looks almost like a triage unit right now, like an wartime situation. We've converted it over.
But you can come down anytime.
Yeah, it's been crazy. So we're looking forward to having people back in there and being happy and lifting their spirits with our spirits.
Yeah, so to speak.
Oh, most definitely. We'll make a toast after this whole thing's done.
That would be great.
Thanks for what you guys do, too. Thank you all very much.
Thanks, you guys. Have a good one.
Thanks, Vince. All right, buddy. See you, my friend.
See you.